Now, Dmitriy, I got to switch gears for a second. Years ago, you told me you were in camp with Mayweather. What do you remember being in camp with Floyd, and what do you remember from Roger? Roger Mayweather just passed away a week ago. Rest in peace, Roger. He always enjoyed talking boxing. What were your interactions like with Roger and with Floyd? You sparred him a few times.
Well, I trained at the top ranked gym when both Floyd and I were top ranked. This goes 2002, 2003, 2004. Those years, I was in probably four or five camps. You know, Roger is a PhD in boxing, a doctorate. You know, really knew the game and
the
and
history, everything.
Everything, the history, the training, just. You know, a wealth of knowledge, and the you know the pad routine that everybody tries to imitate now, you know, started by the Mayweather family. I have one interesting story. I remember we were at the gym. And it was like after one of Floyd's fights. I thought we were just hanging out, and then this guy comes into the gym, heavyweight. He's like, I want to get some boxing, you know. And there was nobody, and he was just like talking a lot of smack. And there was nobody that big to spar, you know. So Floyd was like, Leonard, get my stuff from the car. And Leonard went in the car, got his gear. Floyd got in the ring with him. 30 seconds, shoulder roll and blocking, just that. He's the guy with a body shot and drops the guy. Right?
Wow, a heavyweight.
Yeah, and the guy could fight, you know? And then Roger says, he said, man, somebody start up between the street. You ain't going to say I need to go to training camp for 6 weeks. He said, if you're a real fighter, you get in there and you fight. That's what Floyd did, you know? And it takes that spirit and that training since you're a kid to have that kind of mindset to be a great fighter. And you know, something great like Floyd Mayweather doesn't happen by accident, and I witnessed how hard they worked, how hard they trained, the routine that they established. I mean, every day was different but the same in some ways, and every camp was different but the same level of intensity, the routine that they had and the work they put in together. So you know, Roger's a big part of that. You know, I was had the fortune of being able to witness it, hit the pads with Roger a couple of times myself. Great trainer, you know, one of the great boxing personalities, a wealth of knowledge, and he definitely will be missed.
What do you remember from sparring Floyd? I mean, today Floyd spars 15 minutes, 22 minutes, no breaks, and he just goes and goes and goes, like the Energizer Bunny. How was it back then?
Yeah, it was 4 minute rounds with 15 second breaks.
That's nothing. What's 15 seconds?
Well, you know, I didn't know how tough it was until I got in the ring with him. And there was Roger and there were some other young fighters that were with him. You know, the gym talk stuff. I mean, Floyd was actually getting ready for his rematch with Jose Luis Castillo.
And so he stopped him in the rematch.
135 pounds, yeah. So it was great. Floyd gave me a bit of a black eye, but it was, you know, and actually I fought like a week later or 10 days later, and I still had a little bit going to the ring, and everybody's like, well, Floyd gave it to him. So you know, it's like a trophy.
You're not surprised about his success. Leonard's doing great as a promoter. Mayweather Promotions are putting on sellout shows at Sam's Town and other places. And Badu Jack's a champion. Gervonta Davis, one of the biggest names in boxing or in sports. Gervonta Davis, Ryan Garcia, give me your assessment. What do you think?
Great fight. If they would fight today, I would have to pick Gervonta Davis because he's too experienced. He's had he's fought better level of competition and fought on that level longer. Garcia, I haven't seen enough of him against tough guys. He's very talented, obviously very popular. Has an Oscar-ish type of charm to him. But I haven't seen enough of him to say that he could hang in there with guys like Gervonta Davis. I know that he scored a couple of exciting knockouts, but I haven't seen yet the seasoning to say that he can beat somebody like a Gervonta Davis. But it's great to see that these two young fighters are, you know, talking back and forth.
It's amazing. It's great to build up. The build up, this pay-per-view will be insane. Ryan, sure. 5 million followers, Tank 2.5, and then Leonard with his experience, they just sold out Atlanta. They sold out Baltimore with Gervonta, of course. Amazing. Ryan sold out in L.A., the Honda Center.
I mean, it's amazing. And, you know, and talking about those early training camps with Roger, you know, I remember seeing Leonard there, and you know, Leonard really experienced the boxing game on so many different levels, and that's really great because that's real knowledge that you build from those type of experiences, from being with working with different promoters, seeing all kinds of situations in the gym and in the boxing life, you know. Lena's a great guy. I've always had a good relationship with him, and Mayweather's doing big things. It's great to see.